Hello friends, if you want to conduct a root cause analysis for a problem or situation, mainly three types of basic tools are used in addition to the five whys. These are Pareto chart, shows on a bar graph which factors are more significant. Second, Fishbone or Ishikawa diagram. It identifies many possible causes for an effect or problem and sorts ideas into useful categories. And the third one is scatter diagram. It graphs pairs of numerical data with one variable on each axis to help you look for a relationship. You had already seen Pareto chart and fishbone diagram in my last two videos in very detail. In this video, I am going to explain the third basic tool, that is scatter diagram, in detail. So let's begin. Scatter diagram. It is also called as scatter plot, XY graph and correlation chart. The scatter diagram graphs pairs of numerical data with one variable on each axis to look for a relationship between them. If the variables are correlated, the points will fall along a line or curve. The better the correlation, the tighter the points will hug the line. When to use a scatter diagram? When you have paired numerical data. When your dependent variable may have multiple values for each value of your independent variable. When trying to determine whether the two variables are related, such as when trying to identify potential root causes of the problems. After brainstorming causes and effects using a fishbone diagram to determine objectively whether a particular cause and effect are related. When determining whether two effects that appear to be related both occur with the same cause. And when testing the autocorrelation before constructing a control chart. Scatter diagram example. Let's see a simple example of ice cream shop. The local ice cream shop keeps track of how much ice cream they sell versus the noon temperature of that day. Here are their figures for the last 12 days. And here is a scatter plot of the data. It is now easy to see that warmer weather leads to more sales, but the relationship is not perfect. Now let's see some of the scatter diagram considerations. Even if the scatter diagram shows a relationship, do not assume that one variable caused by the other. Both may be influenced by the third variable. When the data are plotted, the more the diagram resembles a straight line, the stronger the relationship. If a line is not clear, statistics determine whether there is a reasonable certainty that a relationship exists. If the statistics say that no relationship exists, the pattern could have occurred by the random chance. We can see this in detail in my next video. If the scatter diagram shows no relationship between the variables, consider whether the data might be stratified. If the diagram shows no relationship, consider whether the independent variable has been varied widely. Sometimes a relationship is not apparent because the data don't cover a wide enough range. Think creatively about how to use a scatter diagram to discover a root cause. Drawing a scatter diagram is a first step in looking for a relationship between the variables. Now let's see the scatter diagram procedure in Excel. Step 1. Open the worksheet that contains the data that you want to plot into the scatter chart. Let's have an example of study time versus mark obtained in a particular examination. Step 2. Select the data which you want to plot in the scatter chart. Step 3. On the Insert tab in the Charts group, click Scatter. Step 4. Select the scatter chart type and you will get the scatter diagram as below. We can see that a student is likely to score more marks if he or she studies more. Now let's see the scatter diagram procedure in Minitab. Step 1. Copy the data from Excel file into the Minitab worksheet. Step 2. Click in the graph menu and select scatter plot to draw the scatter diagram. Step 3. Scatter plot window will be opened. Select the simple option. Step 4. In Y variables, select as a study time and in X variables, select as a marks and then click OK. You will get the scatter diagram as below. Matrix scatter plot. This is used to test relationship between more than two variables. Mini software supports matrix scatterplot, which allows visualizing relationship between pairs of multiple variables in a single chart. In Minitab, procedure for drawing matrix scatterplot is similar to the scatterplot. Only change is you have to select a matrix plot option instead of scatterplot option. This figure shows matrix scatterplot of strength, pressure and concentration. In the first column of matrix scatterplot, we can see relationship among strength versus pressure and strength versus concentration. Now we've seen what is the scatter plot. Now how to read the scatter plot? If the variables are correlated, the points will fall along a line or curve. The better the correlation, the tighter the points will hug the line. As we can see in the diagram, degrees of correlation varies from no correlation to the perfect correlation, identified by distribution of points along the line. Relationship between the variables can be of four types. Positive correlation. It means there is an increase in level of one variable after increase in level of another variable. Second, negative correlation. There is a decrease in level of one variable after increase in level of another variable, and vice versa. Third, curved. It is a combination of positive and negative correlation. Fourth, partial. There is a relation between variables up to a certain range and thereafter some random behavior. Please like the video if you have found it useful. Add your valuable comments and suggestions. Share this video with all your friends and families who need it and subscribe my channel. I will share similar useful information with you, which will help you to improve your knowledge and experience in the future. To get the notifications of new videos on my channel, please go to YouTube settings, notifications, learn and apply, and click on the bell icon. And finally, thank you for watching.